So we started the company in 2011 as a very small, it's still a very small company, and purpose was to create an emulation which differs from all other emulations so far. Every other simulation depends on DSPs or a computer VST plugin or something like that. So a processor is involved, which takes always some time to calculate the sounds and it makes some latency. And we want to eliminate the latency by a complete different approach, by putting the original circuit and the original physical model of a B3 or an H100 in this case, organ in an FPGA, that's a gate array where you can put not a program in, but a circuit. So what we created was a circuit of the original organ. And it didn't take any much more effort. If you take the original circuit and the original physical model, it sounds like a Hammond. Main problem is the tone wheels are spinning all the time. So you need a lot of computer power to keep all these things running. And the FPGA does everything in parallel. So it's much more easier for the FPGAs to emulate the Hammond generator with the 91 or 96 tone wheels than and DSP, who has to care of everything in serial. FPGA does everything in parallel. Most approaches did use sampling technology in the past, even the first ones, even the last ones. So what we did is a complete different design. If you take an FPGA, you can create the waves the tone wheels produce and emulate it in a way that is more a physical model in terms of each gear, each flutter of the gear, and so on. So the good point of the FPGA is it is hardware. It is not software. So it can't crash. It can't make any blue screens like a computer VST or so. So it works all the time, and everything is working in parallel in it. So the vibrato delay line is in parallel working with the tone wheels. The contacts are emulated in a very decent way. So you can even tweak the parameters of the spring flexing and the spring damping of the contacts itself. So it is very sophisticated.
Ich mache erstmal ein paar einzelne Töne.
Yeah. it sounds like you started this project a long time ago.
The first project was replacing one note in a defective Hammond console. There was one note missing, and everyone knows taking this generator apart is a pain in the ass. So what I did was designing a little circuit which just produces one note, the missing note. And I realized that producing one note for an FPGA is the same as producing 91 or 96 notes at the same time. So it was no big leap for the next step, emulating the complete generator. The further steps were emulating the preamp in the Hammond and emulating the vibrato line, which is a little bit more complicated, and last step was emulating the Leslie, which is an acoustic effect. That's not the. That's more DSP kind of stuff. It is not FPGA. So it was a hard work to get these acoustical simulations working. The organ itself was easy. I can talk about the easy parts. The generator is the easy part. Generator is an easy part because it just produces some waves. It is a physical modeling of the tone wheels itself, so they flutter, they have a little bit slip and so on, so the phase relationship of the notes is not always the same as in other digital instruments, and which leads to a very live feeling sound. It lives, mm-hmm. So if you know what I mean. And the most complicated part in the Hammond emulation itself was the vibrato line, because it's not just a delay, it's more than that. It is a phase and relationships and so on. That's a tricky part. So welcome to our lab of Keyboard Partner. It's always messy like this, so there's lots of work going on, and I would like to show you how the board looks like, which is inside the instruments, and that's it. And the main part of the board is the FPGA, this small black piece right here. That's the FPGA. It does all the sound synthesis and all the sound emulation and the physical modeling and the amplifier simulation and the Leslie emulation. It's all inside this little small box. And it is not even capable of a B3 emulation. It is also capable of a transistor organ emulation like the Vox Continental or the Versi and Böhm organs of the 70s and everything you even can imagine, which is an organ in a common sense. It can emulate everything because it has not only the mechanical contacts emulated, but also the electronic gating, which is present in the 70s organs, and it has a transistor-like tone generator and a single note generator. You can emulate any organ from the 60s to the 80s with it. So we have a lot of fans even in the UK, which prefer these Versi and Böhm organs of the 70s and the 80s, and the sounds of Franz Lambert and Klaus Wunderlich and so on. So they do like the product as well.
So what I ended up doing is doing a transplant and putting the HX3 in here. The HX3 can interface with a lot of different keyboard systems. So I was able to put it in here with a few modifications. Seems to have a slightly heavier tone than the Hammond Suzuki. One other tidbit I'd like to leave about this instrument, the HX3, Karsten over at Keyboard Partners. It's an ever evolving instrument. He's constantly updating between the algorithm of the tone generator, the preamp, and the Leslie simulator. Constantly making changes, And whenever he finds an improvement, he puts it right out there. And that's great. I think that's awesome. It's just like if you owned a regular keyboard and you're getting updates and it's making your keyboard better as time goes on. I think anybody that owns a product would love that. And that's what he does with this. So considering what the HX3 sounded like when I first heard one, and now it's constantly moved up and evolved and gotten better. That's just a little tidbit I wanted you to know. Thank you.
Thank you.